show our ninth straight month of job loss. Nine straight months of job loss. And just 2 weeks ago, Don McCain said the fundamentals of the economy were strong. I don't know what your state Senator McCain uses, but where I come from, there's nothing more fundamental than a job. Because despite my opponent's best efforts to make him think otherwise, this is the philosophy he's embraced during his 26 years in Washington. Over the past few days, he's talked a lot about getting talked about Wall Street, but over the past few decades, he's fought against the very rules of the world to stop the system. He says to take on corporate lobbyists. And he put seven of the biggest lobbyists in Washington in charge of his campaign. If you think those lobbyists are working day and night to elect them just to put themselves out of business, well, I got a bridge to sell you up in Alaska. We know the next 4 years don't have to look like the last eight. We know we can steer ourselves out of this crisis. Because that's who we are.
That's who we are.
Because this is America.
It's America.
We're a nation that's faced down war and oppression. Great challenges, great threats. And at each and every moment, we've risen to meet these challenges because we've never forgotten that fundamental truth. And here, in this country, our destiny is not written for us, it's written by us. Into our own hands once again and reclaim our economic future. I'll give President time to keep the promise that's made year after year by providing the funding our automakers need to retool their factories, make fuel efficient, and alternative fuel cars and trucks. We made some progress. We got some loan guarantees passed out of Congress, but we're going to need the next administration to push this through fast, to be firm, to be serious, to not wait 6 years before he meets with the auto leaders in this state. We need someone who's engaged and focused on making sure that the law and the law are built right here in the U.S. today, and that's not going to be around the country of the United States. Listen, because I see a lot of young people here.
Believe in yourself. Believe in each other.
believe in a future that we can go together. Because together we cannot fail. We cannot fail together. I want to hear the voices of song and the comedy and say, I know there's so many Americans out of work, out of their homes. I know their families can't afford to even see a doctor, much less send their child to college. People can't pay their bills at the end of the month. I know there's a generation that's counting on us to give them the same opportunities, the same chances that we had for ourselves. We can do this. Americans have done this before. And you know, the reason we're able to do it is because of earlier generation, they were willing to look at the future even when the present is tough. Everybody here has a story. Somebody out there, you got a story about your parents, your grandparents, and maybe said, I can't go to college, but my child can go to college. I think I'm never going to get a chance to start my own business, but my child, she can start her own business. I may have to rent a cold water flat, but maybe someday my child will have a home they can call her own. I may not have a pension to retire on, but I can fight to make sure my child or my grandchild has a pension they can rely on. I may live in a country where we don't have freedom of speech or freedom of religion, but I see a country called America.